Hello everyone. Welcome to the 11th video of the Adobe After Effects tutorial from beginner to advanced. In this video, I will teach you how to do simple video editing in After Effects. First of all, you should know that After Effects software is not specifically made for video editing, but it can work as a video editing tool. Usually, after editing the video in Premiere or similar programs, we use After Effects to create animations and special effects. However, sometimes we need to edit videos in After Effects. In After Effects, there are different ways to edit video, which we discuss in this video. First, I create a composition with dimensions of 1920x1080. 29.97 frame rate is usually used in America, and 25 frame rate in Europe. I name the composition Video Editing. I set the composition time to 30 seconds. I import the video files that I want to edit. If you have a lot of video files, it is better to number or name them in advance, so that you can find them more easily during video editing. First, I want to edit video number 1, so I double-click on this video. Now, next to the composition panel, another panel called Footage is created, which allows us to edit the video. Note that we have not yet inserted the file into the timeline. There is also a time indicator in the footage panel, which can be moved during the video. We can also watch the video by pressing the space button on the keyboard. Pressing the space button again stops the movement of the time indicator. This box displays the exact time of the time marker location during the video. The length of this video is 16 seconds, but for example, for this project, I want the length of each video to be 5 seconds. So we have to cut this video to 5 seconds. I put the time indicator in the cut place, for example, I want this video to start from second 4. I click on the set and button to make the cut. Now I set the time indicator to 9 seconds and click on the set out button. In this way, I created the beginning and end of the cut for 5 seconds, which are marked with green color. Although we created these cuts, we can still watch the entire video in the footage panel. Now I set the time indicator in the timeline panel to the desired location to insert the cut we created into the timeline. Note that by selecting the time indicator in the timeline, the composition panel is now activated. I set the time indicator to frame 0 and go back to the footage panel. I click on the overlay edit option, in this way the 5-second video we created will enter the timeline panel. If I put the time indicator at the end of this slice, 5 seconds is inserted in the time display. This highlight bar also shows how long our video was before cutting. After editing the first video, I double-click on the second video to activate the footage panel for this video. This time, by double-clicking on preview time, I set the time to start cutting. I set 6 seconds and click OK. In this way, the time indicator will be at 6 seconds. This time, instead of clicking the set and button, I press the Alt plus left bracket buttons on the keyboard to create a cut. I will teach you different ways of cutting and editing, so that you can learn all the possibilities of After Effects. I double-click the preview time again to set the end time of the cut. I confirm on the 11th second, so that the length of the cut will be 5 seconds. Again, instead of the set out button, we can use the shortcut Alt plus right bracket to cut the end of the video. Here, there are two keys to transfer the video to the composition panel, and we will check their differences. First, I set the time indicator to 2 seconds and go back to the footage panel. If I click on the overlay edit button, the new video will enter the timeline from where I placed the time indicator. And it is placed in the upper layer. I'll delete this layer and go back to the footage panel, this time I'll choose Ripple Insert Edit. Now you can see that the previous video is divided into two layers, and the new layer is created from where I placed the time marker between these two layers. I press the space button to watch the video. So you learned the difference between Overlay Edit and Ripple Insert Edit. I hit Ctrl plus Z a few times to go back a few steps. I put the time indicator at the end of the first video. I go back to the footage panel and click the overlay edit option. As a result, the new video starts after the previous video. I double-click on the third video and cut the video for 5 seconds. I put the time indicator at the end of the previous video and return to the footage panel. I click on the overlay edit option. The third video cut is also entered. This time I do the editing in a different way. I insert the fourth video directly into the timeline and make it the topmost layer. If I place the mouse on the edge of this layer, the shape of the mouse will change, and we can shorten the video by dragging. By holding the shift button, the time indicator snaps to the edge of the bar. And by holding the shift button, I match the starting edge of this layer with the layer below. I also shorten the end of the tape by dragging and match it with the end of the bottom tape. Because the layer below was 5, this layer will be created for 5 seconds too. Now by dragging the tape, I will place the beginning of it at the end of the third video. I will shorten videos 5 and 6 in the same way and put them at the end of the previous video. In the same way, we were able to edit a video in After Effects, and it does not need further explanation. I press the space button to see the result. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. I'll see you next time.